I just came across a very fun deck, and I am not sure if this goes on the meme scale or in the competitive scale, so today I am going to be showcasing this Excalibur deck for you guys, and we are going to be trying to find out if this deck is actually any good in the ranked ladder. This is the deck that I wanted to talk about today. If we have a quick look at the mana curve, you are going to see that this deck has a lot of early game cards, and honestly it is kinda difficult to categorize it between a control or an aggro deck. And the reason is that while this deck has a lot of control cards, we can actually pull off a combo very early on into the game and actually win by turn 5 or 6. Let me explain the cards and how this deck is going to work. This is a relic version. We are going to utilize our weapons in order to win games. And we only have 3 weapons actually in this deck. Those weapons are Dragonfang, and the other one is Scythes of the Harvest. The first thing that I noticed when I came across this deck in the ranked ladder was that while we have Dragonfang, this deck actually doesn't have any dragons, and my first thought was, how is this even going to work? We are going to utilize Dragonfang because it has Leech, and this can help you survive a very difficult early game against some aggro decks. Our win condition in this deck is going to be to buff up our relic as much as we can, and maybe try to win on 2 turns or even pull a 1 turn KO. So let's immediately head into the gameplay, and honestly the starting hand is kind of good. I'm just going to go with this. Let's get rid of Claw and Fang. The Encumbered Looter is very good. Let me start by playing I need a weapon. That is immediately going to give me a Dragon Fang, since I already have that. And now this relic, guys, is actually very strong. We can regenerate up to 8 health with it. Blazing Talisman for my opponent, that's okay. Let me just attack this here, let's draw a card. And then in all honesty, I can just play the Dragonfang. Basically guys, in this deck we have Blood Price to help us draw some cards to activate our combo. We have Carnage Sweep to take control of the board if we play against a Zoo deck. So honestly, all around I think that this deck is very well thought out. What is this creature? Well, we're playing a casual game, so it makes sense that we will see some stuff like that. Let me attack my opponent directly, and then I can draw 2 cards with Blood Price. There is part of the combo. Yep, and I think I can also play I need a weapon to use the extra 2 mana. Guys, it's not looking too bad, actually. That is a Blade Fly for my opponent. We can actually get rid of that very, very easily. So let me just use Savage Strike. Then I can just use my God Power, and then I'm going to trade one of those as well. And guys, we already have a card in my hand that buffs a relic. Let me just play you on the board as well, since we have an extra mana to spare right now. Again, as you can see, we can clear the board very, very easily now. I guess I am going to attack directly. And then I can play Ori Crash for one. And then I am going to use my God Power to get rid of that creature. And honestly guys, I think I could just refresh this relic, just so that I don't waste the mana now. Honestly, I think I'm going to play this relic now. I just want to showcase the combo. I'm not trying to optimize our game plan here. I'm just going to play the Encumbered Looter, and then guys, I'm going to play this relic on the board, so that we can start buffing it up. Oh, that's a very strong creature, but I can clear this very, very easily. Let me just... Actually, you know what? I'm going to take the damage to my face. I'm going to play the Whetstone here. That's going to give 8 strength to my relic. And then I can play Unrestrained Power to make sure that my relic is at 16 damage. Sorry. I'm going to end my turn after I attack. Let's draw another card. And guys, on the next turn, we can be winning this game. I didn't optimize this specific game. I just wanted to showcase how this can work. And as you can see, unless my opponent now plays a very strong frontline creature, we can win the game. Best Friends is not going to be enough. Now I can just play Unrestrained Power again to make sure that this relic has 32 attack, guys, and I can just end my turn after attacking, and this is game over. Obviously, this was a casual game, not very competitive, but this is indeed a very fun combo that I want to try out now in a ranked game. Hey guys, so this is a second game that I'm just playing in the ranked ladder. Let's see how this deck is going to work. We're playing against the Wars. Mobilized is good, but not yet. I need a weapon, is much better. Let me get rid of the Dragon Fang, since we have that. Let me immediately play I need a weapon here, because I do need a weapon. We're getting the Dragon Fang, which is probably going to help us survive a little bit. Let me put Dragon Fang on the board, because that... Do I want to try to use the extra mana? No, let's wait. Oh wow, Okay, so my opponent is playing a very aggressive deck. Oh, and another Hearts of Bronze. How do we deal with that now? No idea whatsoever. Okay, so let me just put you down on the board. Then I am going to attack directly with my Relic. Let's start chipping away at my opponent. I'm recovering some health along the way. That is a Blitz creature from my opponent, but honestly doesn't really do much. I guess we need to play Sharpen here to survive another turn. Let me do just that actually. Sharpen all the way. Then I'm going to get rid of you with you. Then let's get rid of you. Oh, Whetstone is going to be good. And then I can actually play the Woodcutter in. Yep, and now we have the board. My opponent is going to find a very, very easy board clear, but that is okay, but without too big of a threat on the board. And we get... What we get is actually quite okay. Let me just attack my opponent directly to heal for two more, and I'm going to end my turn. Oh! That is actually quite good for my opponent. I mean, I can play Retaliation to get rid of one of you. Then I can actually just play you. And then I can make a very, very easy trade happen. I am also going to take this creature. Let's throw that on the board after I use my mana. So that I can mana search Claw and Fang, and at the same time I can draw a card on the next turn. Now would be a great time for us to actually draw a weapon. And during Shield, that is okay. Yeah, let's get rid of that immediately. Oh, Jump Hue Strike is actually huge. Let's play it. Let's get... What do I want to get? Actually, Retaliation might be good here. Because my opponent is probably going to play a creature now. And give it protected. Oh, nothing. That also works. Here is Carnage Sweep. Now we really need to find ourselves a Relic. But that is not going to happen yet, so let me just, I guess, end my turn. Yeah, that's going to be it. Deadly Arsenal for my opponent, okay, that's going to be a lot of buffs. But exactly as our plan, Retaliation is going to give us some insane value right now. Where is my Relic? Let's play Retaliation onto that, then I can play you. And I'm going to end my turn. That's another strong creature for my opponent. That's another... We really need to find the Relic anytime now. So, I can draw another card first. Let's start like that. Encumbered Looter is good. Let's see how we're going to get rid of that. Let me actually just play you to break the protected from this creature. Then I can attack my opponent directly. Let's get rid of you. Then I can play you. And do I just want to heal up a little bit? I can do that. Yep, sounds about right. Honestly, guys, it's not looking too bad. We still need to find our winning condition, but we have managed to take control of the board. Now, that's a very strong creature for my opponent. Are we going to get rid of that? No, that's not my Relic. Okay, so let me get rid of you. Let's deal one more damage to my opponent. Let me attack here. Let's draw another card. Where is my Relic, please? Jaskia is... an okay creature for me to play right now. And yeah, I guess we just can end our turn. Guys, we still haven't found our win condition. We have two relics in 8 cards. Overproof blue. Oh, wow. Oh, my opponent is going to attack me directly. I think that might be a slight mistake. Carnage Sweep is not good enough, but I guess I need to play you empowered so that we can get rid of all of those creatures. Yep, now I can attack here directly. We are not going to draw any more cards, but that is okay. Because honestly, guys, I'm just going to play Claw and Fang. Let's get rid of this creature. And now we can just wait, basically, because we have all the pieces of the puzzle, but we don't have the actual puzzle itself. Where is my Relic? Come on, we have 3 cards that can give us a Relic now. That is another strong creature for my opponent we really need to find. A good card now to play. Dragon Fang is good because I can start buffing it up, guys. Okay, so Dragon Fang is here. And honestly, yeah, I need to start buffing it up. And I am also going to play Carnage Sweep on this turn to make sure that this creature doesn't survive. Then I can do that. I can play Carnage Sweep. I'm trying to think how we can... Can we win on the next turn? No, we still... Yeah, actually we win, because my opponent... Yeah. We didn't pull the combo off, but we managed to actually win a very competitive game, it seems like. So, honestly, okay, we'll take that, we'll take that. While this deck is not very flashy always, we might not get to pull the combo off, we can actually win some games with it. So, I'm still trying to determine if it's actually a good idea to take this deck into the ranked ladder. This is the deck list. You can actually find it in the description of my video. I'll make sure to put that there. Let me know what you thought about this deck, and let me know what... What is that? Anyway, let me know what you thought about this deck. And before I end this video, don't forget that we have a huge giveaway for the Swallowhole Diamond Edition. All you need to do is make a comment on this video, and that immediately gives you one entry. Guys, thank you so much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed today's video. I'll see you all tomorrow with a brand new deck idea.